Hello everyone. As far as you all know, in the previous video I have discussed quality of service. So basically in any enterprise, how they measure the performance and capability using these two tools. One is quality of service and second is quality of experience. So now in this particular video, I'll be discussing the quality of experience and how to deal with all these things. So we'll see the motivations of QE in this particular video. I will try to define the quality of experience and what are the factors are there which could influence quality of experience, and let's see what are the different various applications area of quality of experience. So this is the index. Let's begin our journey. Why QE? Just look at this diagram. So basically, before the advent of the public internet, video content delivery was a monopoly of content publishers who deliver their products and services over closed video delivery systems. We used to call them cable TV, and managed by the cable, you all know, and the satellite TV operators. And the operators owned and operated the entire distribution chain as well as the video reception device, which we used to call set-top boxes. You can see here, in the history, we can say, we used to have this STV, that is set-top box, and we used to be like subscriber, and this was the traffic scheduling system, the playout system, getting encoding and using the multiplexing techniques, modulator, and then uplink to the server, to the satellite, and using the dish TV, used to get this. And these closed networks and devices were under the full control of these operators, and were designed, deployed, provisioned, and optimized specifically to deliver high quality video to consumers. So the traffic scheduling system here provides audio video content via the playout system to be encoded and aggregated into a single MPEG transport stream together with the program specification PSI. The transport stream transmitted to subscriber set-top box via satellite. So this was the thing which was really trending. Then the actually concept got changed, and the concept came of online video content delivery. So video delivery over the internet takes a different approach, because numerous sub networks and devices that constitute the internet are situated in varied geographical areas. Video streaming reached the user by traversing through uncharted territories and all. So the internet service provider do not own the entire content. You can see we have got various internet service providers, but they don't own it, and the risk of quality degradation is high. The access network may consist of coaxial cable, copper cable, or fiber or wireless cable technology. Issues such as a packet delay, jitter, and loss of may such networks, etc. So as you all can see here, the user have got the different end user end devices. But of course, users have subscribed to the various other internet service providers. But the content deliver network, you can see, is getting to every internet service provider. And this service provider may have implemented technology by using coaxial cable, copper, fiber, or wireless. So totally, we can actually expect the quality which we are getting here will not be same here. So the growth and the expansion of the internet over the past couple of decades has led to an equally huge growth in the availability of network-enabled video streaming services. We have experienced like how the internet has grown and how the video streaming has become really easy nowadays. So giant technology strides have also been made in the development of network access devices. User standards are often influenced by the typically high video quality experience with the older technology, what user expect. And that is those offered by the cable and satellite TV operators. So user expectation can also be influenced by the capability that currently can only be adequately offered by broadcast TV. This capability includes the following. One is trick mode, and second is contextual mode. So a trick mode is like a playback feature. It should be there in any mode, like forward, playback at the recorded speed, the audio and video content by 1x speed. Example including fast forward, slow motion, reverse, and random access. Now what user is expecting. And what we call contextual experiences like across multiple screens, which includes the ability to pause the viewing on one screen and switch to another, thus letting the user take the video experience with them on the go. So this is what the user now expecting. So you can see how the history has got changed, how the technology has evolved, how the experience which user are facing, and how their expectations are getting increased day by day. Next is service failures due to inadequate quality of experience consideration. So we all know the concept of 3D. So the stereoscopic 3D TV service is often cited as a prime example of a service. There was a spectacular commercial failure because it had a very poor quality of experience ratings. In 2010, broadcasters such as Disney, Foxtel, BBC actively making 3D content delivery available as a service to their customers. So indeed, each of these broadcasters rolled out their own dedicated 3D television channels. So within 5 years, all of them except Sky terminated their operations. A number of factors contributed to the failure of the services. Like the first was general unavailability of the wow video content. So basically that factor was missing, a wow. So the second was the need to wear a special 3D glasses even when using this service in the home environment. You must have remembered that blue and red color glasses used to come. So those glasses we are supposed to wear. And third, because broadcasters were initially in a rush to deploy the 3D TV technology, content was produced by inexperienced creators. So basically they wanted to deliver the 3D TV, but they were not actually creating the content by using actual highly embedded technologies and all. So they were not using the system and tools properly, or you can say they were using inadequate systems and tools to actually generate the 3D content. Their focus were like to deliver the 3D TV, but the focus should have put on the creating the 3D content in quality wise. So this was a service failure which happened. Next is quality of experience related standardization projects. So you can just pause the video, you just have to go through the organization and their mission and what quality of experience related effort they have taken. So you can see many organizations here, Qualinet, Eureka, CERTIC, and ITUD, and then IEEE SANET, they have got their mission and what effort they have taken here. Okay, and apart from this, the Video Quality Expert Group, that is VQEG, is currently working on the draft of ITUD recommendation for 3D video quality assessment. And another initiative is by the Quality of Experience Estimators in Network, that is the acronym is QUIN project, which is a multi-organizational and multinational initiative aimed at addressing issues related to online services such as voice, video, and IPTV, etc. As I mentioned this. So basically the QUIN developed an operation framework by categorizing the factors that may have influence on quality of experience into well-defined layers. So in this particular project, they have followed the layered approach. So the QUIN engine was at the core of the layered model. It enabled the flexible deployments of quality of experience estimators in a large-scale distributed environment. So this was the thing, and these other also people are contributing to the 3D technologies. Or you can say quality of experience. Now let me define the quality of experience. See, there are a number of different, although similar or definitions of quality of experience. The nature of quality experience, which turns out to vary from person to person, as you all know. Because having a product or similar product, you can say in the group of people, they have experience that use of that particular product will be different. So quality of experience requires a multidisciplinary approach encompassing communication network, cognitive process, multimedia signal processing, and social psychology. So researchers working within this various discipline often use their own specialist language and terminology in describing the identical concept of quality of experience. Before I proceed, just understand what do you mean by definition of quality. The quality is nothing but a resulting verdict produced by the user after he or she has carried a comparison and judgment process on an observable occurrence or event. As simple as that. And what do you mean by definition? Like, what do you mean by experience? Experience is nothing but an individual description of a stream of perception, like his or her own perception, interpretation of one or multiple events. An experience might result from an encounter with a system, service, or an artifact. Fine. So, what they are experiencing, what their perception, what their intervention, or not intervention, but interpretation and all for the towards something is nothing but an experience. Look at this diagram now. Okay, so we have got two paths here. One is reference path and second is perception path. How the quality ratings described is that by using this particular model, you can say, or you can say it is nothing but a framework. So the reference path here reflects the temporal or like time according to the time and contextual nature of the quality formation process. This path is influenced by the memories you have of former experience qualities as integrated by the or from experience quality to the like reference path, you can say. So basically you have got former experience, and the perception path is characterized by the physical input signals which is to be assessed reaching the sensory organs of the observer. So basically this is the reference you people have experienced before, and this is the perception to the current technology or you can say current service. And using all those things, anticipation, you make the comparison and judgment, and you are experiencing the quality. Again, you are recording it for the other products, and this is how the quality rating get described here. So finally, the definition of quality experience is nothing but a degree of delight or annoyance of the user of an application or service. How much the user is loving it or hating it. It results from the fulfillment of his or her expectation with respect to the utility, how the particular user or consumer utilizing it or enjoying the application or service in the light of the user's personality and current sales. So this is what we call quality of experience. Quality of experience strategies in practice. So this is what we call, we have got quality of the only model we have got here. The quality of experience and quality of service layered model. As you can see, we have got the four layers. One is user, then service, and the application network. So the starting from the user to the network is nothing but a quality of experience domain. And inside it, the application network where the quality of service domain play a role. So let me describe this one by one. The user interacts with the service, you all know. It is their degree of delight or annoyance from using the service. So the QO, quality of experience at the user level, stems from the difference between the individual user characteristics, of which some might have been time varying. So example would be like including gender, age, attitudes, prior experience, expectations, various other factors. So they have got different perspective related to it. Next is service. The service level provides a virtual level where the user's experience of the overall performance of the service can be measured. It is the interface actually where the user interacts with the service. It is also where the tolerance thresholds are measured. Next is application level quality of service, you can say. Quality of service deals with the control of the application specific parameters such as content resolution, bitrate, frame rate, color depth, coding, decoding type, layering strategy, and sampling rate. The network capacity often dictates the bandwidth that will be allocated to a service for the transmission. And the network, this level is concerned with the low level network parameters such as service coverage, bandwidth, delay, throughput, and packet loss, etc. So if you are maintaining the quality of service here in this particular two levels, application and network, means you are giving the good quality of service. So definitely it will definitely affect the quality of experience domain also. So this is what we call the quality of experience and quality of service layer model. Next is the factors influencing the quality of experience. So there are eight factors, one by one we'll discuss. The first is user demographics. The context of demographic is like hearing refers to the like group of people. So relatively stable characteristics of a user that might have an indirect influence on perception. The grouping of user was based on demographic characteristics such as their attitude towards the adoption of the new technologies. Or socio-demographic information, socio-economic status, and the prior knowledge. Next is type of device. Different type of devices, type poses different characteristics that may impact the quality of experience. So if you are enjoying the video, like if you are watching a video in like low resolution device, definitely you will not enjoy the video. But if you watch those videos in like high resolution device, like in 4K devices, definitely it will increase your experience or increase the quality of experience. Next is content. Content types can range from the interactive content specifically curated according to the person interest, like video on demand. Studies have suggested people tend to watch video on demand. Netflix, you know, Amazon Prime, you all know. Before the the scenario was totally different, where the like cereal used to come at that particular time only. People have to get free at that particular time, and people have to sit in the front of the TV on that particular duration continuously. But now the things have changed. This is what the video on demand content has came up. Next is connection device, connection type. The type of the connection used to access the service influences user. What connection people have got. If you are using 3G connection, in contrast to wireline connection, even when the two connection types are identical, they're in the terms of the technical condition. Exactly. So basically, connection type also matter here, the factor which can influence the quality of experience. Then media quality. This is a significant factor affecting the quality of experience, and it is a part of the service. You all know, if you record the video by using like low resolution camera, so the basically video quality is totally degrading. And if you're recording the video same or recording the content with using the high resolution camera, so definitely the quality will be improving. Next is network. Content delivery via the internet is highly susceptible to the effects of delay, jitter, packet loss, and available bandwidth. So here the network plays a role. So basically our concept is of modern networking, how this particular things is actually can get achieved. So that's a concern. Again, very important factor, Seventh is usability. Another QoE factor is amount of effort that is required to use the service. Or the service design must render the good quality without a great deal of technical input from the users. And the cost, the long established pattern of judging the quality by the price. But of course, everyone thinks if they will, they can afford it, so basically they will be getting the good quality of experience here. The cost. So these are the eight factors influencing the quality of experience. The measurements of quality of experience. There are three ways. That one is subjective assessment, second is objective assessment, and third is end user device analytics. So let's discuss one by one. What do you mean by subjective assessment? See, for subjective assessment of quality of experience, experiments are carefully designed to a high level of control so that the validity and reliability of the result can be trusted. The first thing is the characterize the service. The task at this stage is to choose the quality of experience measure that affects your user experience the most. Okay. Next is design and define the test metrics. So once the service has been characterized, the quality of service factors that affect the quality of experience measure can be identified. So basically you can define the test metrics and design it accordingly. You can test all the factors or categorize the service in those particular metrics and test it. So how about testing such a large combination of parameters may not be feasible. So you can have a metrics approach. Third, specify test equipment and materials. Subjective tests should be designed to specify the test equipment that will allow the test metrics to enforce in a controlled fashion. So you should know the tools and equipment accordingly to test all those things. Identify the sample population. A representative sample population is identified, possibly covering different classes of user categorized by the user demographics, like by using gender or by the attitude towards the technology, etc. Fine. So depending on the target environment for subjective test, at least 24 test subjects has been suggested, an ideal number, and at least 35 test subjects for the public environment. So you can how go for the sample population like this. Fifth is subjective methods. Test subject to be presented with the test condition under scrutiny, along with that set of rating scales should be there. They allow the correlation of the user response with the actual quality of service test condition being tested. Then finally, you have to do the analysis. When the test subjects have rated all of the quality of service test condition, a post-screening process might be applied to the data to remove erroneous data from a test subject that appears to have voted out randomly. Okay, this is all called subjective assessment. Another way is called objective assessment. For objective assessment of quality experience, computational algorithms provide the estimates of audio, video, and audiovisual quality as perceived by the user. So each objective model targets a specific service type. So the goal of any objective model is to find the optimum fit that strongly correlates with data obtained by from the subjective experiments. So in this, you have to go for the first thing, that is database of the subjective data. A starting point might be the collection of a group of subjective data sets, as it could serve as a benchmark for the training. Second is preparation of the objective data now. So the data preparation for the objective model might typically include a combination of the same quality of service test condition as found in the subjective data set. Then methods. There are various algorithms in existence that can provide estimates of audio, video, and audiovisual quality as perceived by the user. Some algorithms are specific to perceived quality artifact, while others can provide the estimate for a wider scope of quality artifacts. Fourth is verification of the result. So the, after the objective algorithm has processed all the quality of service test condition, the predicted values might benefit from the post-screening process. You people have to verify the result, what you people have predicted and actually the actual result. Validation of the objective model. So the objective data analysis might be evaluated with respect to its prediction accuracy, consistency and the linearity by using a different subjective data set. So these are the two ways, like the subjective assessment and objective assessment. And there was one more here, the end user device analytics. That what does it mean? That end user device analytics is yet another alternative method of quality experience measurement. That is, real time data such as the connection time, byte send, average playback rate are collected by the video player application for each video viewing session, fed back to the server module, where the data is again pre-aggregated and turned into the actionable quality of experience measures. So this is what we call end user device analytics. So this has been discussed. So what reference I have taken, this is the book Foundation of Modern Networking by William Salix. I hope you enjoy the video. Thank you so much.